Please be seated. And I invite Andy to come forward to share his words of remembrance with us.
To my hero, you are a Brooklyn-born man who truly had a wonderful life. Because of you, so did we. We come here together today to celebrate you. To a man that came from a blue-collar background, graduated from college, paying for it himself, served 4 years in the military, and worked his way up to VP of underwriting. He would always get his point across in his classic Irish whisper. Memories of my father may hit you at different times. Maybe it will be at Christmas when you say, "Let's watch It's a Wonderful Life," or when you hear someone with a Brooklyn accent and they say that word just a little bit off, or when you see the unconditional love of a grandfather for his grandkids, or just when somebody says, "Pass the ketchup." As horrible as cancer is, God gave me a gift. In Pop's last years of fighting this devastating disease, I got to spend almost every day with him. Today, through my remembrance of him, hopefully, it will bring back your visions of him. In his last days, when he was in the hospital, he wasn't able to say goodbye to each of you, which is what I hope I can do today. I saw Mike Krzyzewski tell a story about how he was very close to Jim Valvano. Coach K was asked, "Can you remember the last thing Jim Valvano said to you?" Coach K said, "You know what? I don't remember the last thing. And the reason I don't is I thought he would live forever. I was always anticipating that next moment. I never understood that story until we lost my father. I thought he'd be here forever." Someone very important to me reminded me, try not to focus on the sadness in the last years of his life. My father was so much more than cancer. He was a man with an incredible gift to connect with people. The man becoming best buds with the golf starter. The random stranger he would tell how great his grandchildren are. Or the fact that he had lifetime friends. In 2012, he took the whole family to Pebble Beach. Yes, I remember playing those famous courses. But it's the other memories that float back to me. Being by the fire pit with the whole family, the bagpiper playing, Pop with the biggest smile holding his grandkids' hands, the enjoyment of the invention of toddler bowling with the classic Hugh laugh. After the third round of golf in Pebble Beach, Pop asked a father and son caddy team to go in for a drink at the bar. The longtime caddy said to my dad, "I've been doing this for 25 years. I've never been asked to have a drink." It didn't matter him where you came from or your status. A good person was a good person. Knowing my father, on the first Sunday in heaven, he probably talked his way into a foursome with Bobby Jones, Arnie Palmer, and Ben Hogan. And he would then proceed to tell everybody he won $2 off them. On May 5th, I know Eddie Kane, John Fagan, Johnny Fuchs, and Big Lair were there with open arms to welcome in. The man whose grandkids meant everything to him. Is this the same man I grew up with? I want to tell the kids, nope. With Greg, Trish, and me, he was a disciplinarian, but loving, giving, and fun. With his grandkids, he was a big softy. To the grandkids, he was the proudest guy in the world for each one of their accomplishments. There were so many memories of the legendary Pop-Pop. Lucas, sitting on the porch with Pop counting the birds and cars, he told everybody you were a genius at puzzles. Morgan, FaceTiming, going back and forth. You the best. I will never forget the sound of you saying, "Pop, pop," to get his attention. Pop saying, "There goes my golden boy." He never doubted Chase on his knowledge of animal trivia when they played driving to hockey. And by the way, I always saw you sneaking Chase those black and whites. Kendall, the image of you snuggling on Pop-Pop's lap, Pop would tell everyone at Dana-Farber what amazing things you were doing. Basketball, dance, school, art, the list goes on. And for the boy, he was named after him, Hugh Colton. Hockey filled in where golf ended. I will never forget, after scoring, Colton looking up to the stands, seeing Pop-Pop with his trademark fist pump. Colton could do no wrong in his eyes. Colton told us he still looks up in the stands when he makes a good play, hoping against hope to see his Pop-Pop. Each one of us wrestles with the idea of our immortality. How will we be remembered? But I have realized is his nickname, Big Mac, was more than a nickname. My dad was big. He was a presence. People loved him. They remember him because he brought kindness and generosity to this world. You know, someone once said, the true measure of friendship isn't about how you feel about someone else. It's about how they make you feel about yourself. Pop had many friends over his lifetime. His Brooklyn crew, his Guardian, life insurance friends, his Trumbull baseball friends, his Tashua golf buddies, and later in life, his hockey family, who he affectionately called the boys. Several people stuck by him when he was struggling in the last years of his life. He loved you more than you will know. Those check-ins meant the world to my dad. Family meant everything to him. He was the original George Bailey. To the Long Island crew, Kathy, his only sister, who gave their mother and brother a home, who took care of them. He loved his sister. Loved teasing her in a way only a big brother can. She meant the world to him. Patrick, you will never know how much it meant to him when you would give him those Sunday calls for the check-in. But I think what he loved most was you always fell for the stop and go in football. To Bill, AKA Johnny Miller, a golfing buddy and friend. Tim and Janet, family who are also great friends. Traveling companions, where stories would flow after every trip. But what Pop will miss the most is the family gatherings of family he and my mom built. Trish, his sweet pea. There is no love like a father for his daughter. Walking you down the aisle, he was beaming. We always have the memory of you calling him Daddy. He always wanted to know how much he loved you. Greg, he had so much pride telling every person he interacted at Dana-Farber that his son raised $23,000 and ran the Boston Marathon in his honor. So many memories you can cherish of spending time with him, coaching your teams, golfing, travel, and picking you up in the Grand Union parking lot. Kirsten, his daughter-in-law, but you were so much more. And anyone can tell that. You became his advocate, his caregiver, his Tip O'Neill to his Ronald Reagan. He loved you like his own. Never forget that. Steve, the greatest way he could tell you what he thought of you, he gave his blessing to marry his sweet pea. Also, without you, the hole-in-one would not have been official. Eileen, you did not have the privilege to know him that long, but he took his shining from you, from the beginning with you. You made his son and his granddaughter happy, and that made him happy. And to my mom, they had a love story made in heaven, or Brooklyn. 52 years of the life you built together. I'm sure there were tough times, along with all the wonderful memories, but you really, the two of you really showed Trish, Greg, and me what true love was all about. You built a life filled with friends and worldwide travel, but you could also be happy sitting together on the couch, binge-watching your favorite shows. All along, Mom, you were the rock for Dad. You took care of him in so many ways throughout his whole marriage. That's why it was so important for him that you could spend the last night together with him in the hospital. You were the love of his life. Pop, I am sorry I could not take away the frustration. I am sorry I could not take away the pain you experienced. I am sorry I could not take away the fear of that day at Dana-Farber that when they called you with the results. And I am much sorry that you had to leave us much, much too soon. I thought I would give almost anything for one more day with him. But I know I'd be lying. I couldn't just ask for one. So until we meet on the other side, watch over us. Keep us out of trouble and love us as you did. To my pop, my hockey buddy, my best friend, I miss you every day. Rest in peace.